Friday's opening bell at the New York Stock Exchange ushered in a new trading day and a new era for the exchange itself. Presiding over the weekday ritual was Stacey Cunningham, the first woman named to lead the New York Stock Exchange in its 226-year history. We went to Wall Street to meet the woman breaking another glass ceiling.
Is this like breathing life into you again, being when you're out here?
Yes, it always is. It never gets old walking onto the trading floor.
Stacey Cunningham has called the New York Stock Exchange home since 1994.
Your first memory of the New York Stock Exchange is what?
So I was an engineering student, and I through happenstance ended up with an internship on the trading floor. As soon as I heard all the sounds and the energy and the pace, I knew it was home for me.
She climbed the ranks on Wall Street, starting as a floor clerk and specialist, working her way up. Now, 24 years after that New York Stock Exchange internship, Stacey Cunningham is its first female president.
It's it's overwhelming. We have a very high profile role in global commerce, in the capital markets. And so being the face of that is a little intimidating.
When you first started, you were one of few women.
Yes.
What was that like?
I didn't notice it. And
really?
I know that's a surprising answer. I know I was outnumbered. I mean, I can tell the difference between a man and a woman, but it just wasn't top of mind for me.
Thanks in large part, Cunningham says, to Muriel Siebert. Back in 1967, Siebert paved the way, becoming the first woman to own a seat on the New York Stock Exchange.
She kept pushing, and she had to get sponsored to be a woman, and the first nine people she asked said no. You know, and even when she finally did get in, there wasn't a whole lot of support for having her there. So she did that hard work, and so that's inspirational.
But not all the doors were fully opened.
So they turned phone booth number 5. They turned into a ladies' room. Right next to phone booth number 5 was the men's room. And they were literally big saloon doors, attendants, couches, the whole thing. When I left the trading floor in 2005, it was still the phone booth upstairs. It was only within the past 10, 11 years that there was a proper ladies' room there.
Stacey Cunningham isn't the only prominent woman of Wall Street on the move this year. The beloved Fearless Girl statue is heading from a spot in front of the charging bull to her own perch in front of the New York Stock Exchange.
What does that Fearless Girl mean
to you? I think she's the greatest thing. I love her. I think she challenges corporate America to do better. You know, when you look at the number of women in the corner office as CEOs, less than 5% of the Fortune 500 women and not necessarily growing. But for me, I just look at her and I think she is taking on the world and she's not afraid at all.
I absolutely love talking with her. She took a sabbatical during her time there on Wall Street to go to culinary school. She said that kitchen frenzy is like the Wall Street frenzy and that it taught her a lot about communication, which helped her when she returned.
Being in the middle of the fire, so to speak. I love her. Shout out to Muriel Siebert, who was a real pioneer on Wall Street, as she is now.
Yeah, put your head down and charge.
Yeah, very impressive.